Welcome to Greater Faith, where we are moving our faith into action. Here at Greater Faith, we believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. To proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, to maintain the worship of God, and to inspire all persons a love for Christ, a passion for righteousness, and a consciousness of their duties to God and their fellow human beings. We pledge our lives to Christ and covenant with each other to demonstrate His Spirit through praise, worship, faith, and ministry to the needs of the people of this church and the community. Now let's usher the Spirit by giving God the ultimate praise. going to do a little Black History moment. This is called the Freedom Summer. The Daily Voting Rights Campaign, known as Freedom Summer, the successful Black labor rights movement during the Great Depression and the long fight for desegregation in schools are among the many lesser-known stories that help shape our understanding of the U.S. Black history. Black history in the classroom has become a source of contention in K-12 schools, colleges, and universities across the country. In 1964, activists attempted to register as many Black voters as possible in Mississippi in what is known as Freedom Summer or the Mississippi Summer Project. The National Archives recorded that more than 60 churches and homes were bombed or burned, 4 civil rights workers were killed, at least 3 Black Mississippians were killed, 80 workers were beaten, and more than 1,000 people were arrested in connection with the effort. The fight for voting rights was a dangerous and sometimes fatal fight for activists. Our Black history is worth celebrating. Let us never forget.
Amen. Amen. Stand up on your feet this morning. Give God some praise this morning. It is the last Sunday of Black history. But we can never forget Black history. As much as they try to write it out of our history, it's still our history, and it is going to last forever. Amen. We're going to do our scripture prayer and mission statement this morning. At this time, our scripture is coming from the book of Romans, chapter 15. Verse number 13, Romans 15 and 13. I will be reading from the NLT version this morning. And God's word reads, I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust in Him. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord this morning. Let us pray. Most gracious Father God, we thank you for another opportunity, Father God, to worship you this morning. Father God, I just ask you to bless greater faith this morning. Father God, I ask you to bless everyone in attendance this morning. Father God, we ask that you allow this word that you've given this lead servant today, Father God, for him to break it down and make it plain for us, Father God, today. In Jesus' name, I pray and I praise this morning. Amen. We're going to do our mission statement at this time. Our mission statement reads, we the people of greater faith believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ and the beliefs of the Christian faith, to maintain the worship of God and inspire all persons a love for Christ, a passion for righteousness, and a consciousness of their duty to God and to their fellow human beings. We pledge our lives to Christ in covenant with each other to demonstrate His Spirit through praise, worship, faith, and ministry to the needs of the people of this church and to the community. Amen.
Good morning, Great Faith. We hope everyone is having a great morning this morning. It's time to celebrate the Lord this Sunday morning. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
For those of you who would like to give through Cash App or PayPal, our Cash App is $FaithGreater. Our PayPal is GreaterFaith2018@yahoo.com. Once again, our Cash App is $FaithGreater, and our PayPal is GreaterFaith2018@yahoo.com.
Amen.
Oh, Save mine, oh, but a sacrifice you made. praise God. Amen. Can we stand up on our feet and praise God? Come on, church. Come on.
Yes.
Come on, y'all can do better than that. Can we worship it in the spirit?
Yes.
I heard nothing but a half a clap. Amen. Can we give God some praise this morning? Come on, y'all can do better than that. I do the praise team for Luke. Sorry about your song. But that's all right. Y'all still sung that song, and we ready for a word of God. Amen. How many of y'all truly are here to hear a word from God this morning? Come on, come on. How many of y'all really want to hear a word from God this morning? How many of y'all are thankful this morning right now for a simple thing that God has done in your life? How many of y'all really just say, I am so satisfied with what God has done for me? Come on, come on. I believe there's a little bit more power behind them applause right there. How many of y'all just want to say, God, thank you right now? Because you didn't have to do it. Come on. How many of y'all glad that y'all are in the land of the living this morning? Amen. How many of y'all glad that he woke you up this morning and started you on your way? Come on, church. How many of y'all truly blessed right now that you look at your neighbor real quick. Look at him right now. Look at him. And just say, I'm thankful that you are here with me. Amen.
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 I'm thankful this morning, y'all, because in our presence right now is a young lady who celebrated a birthday this week. I'd be less legitimate if I put her age out there, but it's okay. Amen. She's 77 years old right now. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Amen. It's my auntie. And she's been here with me. Amen. And I'm thankful that she's here. I say, come to church. We say, okay. And she's here with us this morning. Celebrating. 77. Don't act like it. Don't look like it. Still can move. Still can dance. Still can do a dance step, auntie. Do a dance step. She's a man. But she's still young, y'all. 77 years of age. Amen. She don't mind because it's taking a lot to get there now. Amen. We also celebrated another young man by the name of Pastor Samuel. It was his birthday this week. Amen. We celebrate his birthday as well. Part of us. And then we had on the 21st, which is the same day as Pastor Orr's birthday, we celebrated my father, my uncle, Robert Brown's birthday was this week. Amen. We celebrated that. Now we've been the same age, right? Been the same age. Look at that. Yeah. And we're saying we're close in every way. And we want to say thank you to each and every person that celebrated a birthday this week. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everyone. It's good to see Tracy in the building this week. All our guests, we're glad to see you here. Even some models in the building today. It's not first Sunday. It's not first Sunday. She's here. Not first Sunday. There is a word from God being this morning. Amen. And if you have your Bibles, I want you to turn to your book of Galatians 5. No, Galatians 6. We're going to go to Galatians 6. Amen. Galatians 6, pick it up from 1 through 9. Galatians 6, verses 1 through 9. Galatians 6 verses 1 through 9. There is a word from God. very excited about this word this morning. I'm also excited about just being in the presence of the Lord to be able to have this platform to deliver his word. And I hope you enjoy it. I hope you take and apply it to your life. I hope you do something spectacular with it and understand what's getting ready to take place this morning. Last week, do anyone remember the title of the sermon last week? This is, I'm always throwing quizzes on the members of Greater Faith, Auntie, and see if we all on one accord. What was the message last week? Anyone knows? This is how we know that we're taking notes or are we even paying attention to the word that's been delivered.
Stop all the mess.
Say it again.
Stop all the mess.
Stop all the mess. All right. Anybody else? That's in your notes?
No.
Okay, amen. That's in your notes. All right. Stop all the mess. All right. Amen. So do we have Galatians 6 verses 1 through 9? You have it, just say amen. All right, now take your fingers. If you don't have your Bibles, you got your phones, you are also welcome to go along with us as we travel through our excitement of having our Bibles. Take your physical Bibles, take your phone, and hold it high in the air. The deacon over here is pointing way across the room. Pull the Bible by itself. All abandoned. Amen. Put your Bibles and your phone high in the air. Come on, Greater Faith. Let's sell out what I guess as well. And what? Wave them like we just don't care. Amen. I got my word this morning. There is a word. There is a word from Galatians. Galatians 6 verses 1 through 9. And God's word reads.
Dear brothers and sisters, if another believer is overcome by some sin, you who are godly should gently and humbly help that person back onto the right path and be careful not to fall into the same temptation yourself. Share each other's burdens and in this way obey the law of Christ. If you think you are too important to help someone, you are only fooling yourself. You are not that important. Pay careful attention to your own work, for then you will get the satisfaction of a job well done. And you won't need to compare yourself to anyone else. For we are each responsible for our own conduct. Those who are taught the word of God should provide for their teachers, sharing all good things with them. Don't be misled. You cannot mock the justice of God. You will always harvest what you plant. Those who live only to satisfy their own sinful nature will harvest decay and death from that sinful nature. But those who live to please the Spirit will harvest everlasting life from the Spirit. So let's not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessings if we don't give up.
Amen. May God have a blessing to the readers and hearers and doers of his holy divine word. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Your translation may read different because she's reading from the NLT version. That's what we're reading from. Just real simple subject today, family. I want to give this a title and say, it's my season. Come on, can I get someone said, it's my now season. Come on, someone say with me, it's my now season. Put some emphasis behind that. It is my now season. Someone say, right now.
Right now.
Is my season.
My season.
Just a brief second, I want to raise up a curiosity in your mind to ask my fellow brothers and sisters this morning to start this time, this service off with this sermon, is to ask you, are you living in your season right now? Are you living in a season where you can see where God is blessing you? Are you living in a season, not only if God is blessing you, but you are working for the Lord in your season? Deacon and Greater Faith and family and friends who are watching, we go through different seasons through our life. And we tend to sometimes forget that we are working for the Lord. We go through seasons where that sometimes they can be cloudy. Sometimes we go through seasons where we can't see prosperity. We go through seasons that we don't know what's going on. We go through seasons that we just want to ask God for a break. And I'm the only one that truly has asked God for a break in a season, because sometimes that life can be a little bit overbearing. Sometimes life can be practically a little bit too much, mother and family. Sometimes that you turn around and you got friends and church members that they can be just a little bit too much. I got to ask Lord, Lord, I just need a break from all this that's going on. I need a break from all this pain that's in my body. I need a break from all this debt that I'm in. I need a break right now, even for parents who have kids. I need a break right now from a job right now. It's overbearing, it's stressing me out. I need a break right now. And in this season, God, I'm trying to find my purpose. I'm trying to find my way. In this season, God, I'm trying to find out what you will have me to do. Is there anybody by hands here saying, I have been in a season when I have been asking God, God, show me what I need to be doing. God, show me what you want me to do. God, show me who you want me to speak to. God, I'm in a season right now, God, and I'm barely hanging on, God. Amen. I want to trust you, God, in this season, but this season has not been everything that I have been what anticipated or what I expected. This season has came with me losing my family, losing a house, losing some money, losing a job. Is there anybody in here with me right now saying, even though we're in the beginning of a new year, but this season has already been rough. I have been behind on everything. I have been stressed out about everything. I've been talked about. I've been overlooked in this season right now. Is there anybody saying, I have more doctor visits than I had more what? Appraisals. Is anybody going to testify this morning and say that in this season, God, I want to trust you, but I'm running into more walls and I'm running into more dead ends in this season. Someone got to be shouting right now. Said, thank goodness, though, Father, that the season isn't over. Although I'm experiencing all these things, God, I know there's still what more to come. And I got to have somebody say, if I just press through, amen, a little rough season, then I know that the end is going to be better than than the start. In this season, dear auntie, God is talking to us and telling us just to hang on. In just a little while longer, things will get better. We just got to be able to persevere through these bad times, persevere through these tough times, persevere through these rough times. We can't give up every time that we're faced with small obstacles. We can't give up when we face with setbacks. A lot of us throw in the towel on God when we don't get anything that we have asked. We throw in the towel on God and say, he's not answering my parents. He's not answering me talking to. We throw in the towel on God when he don't come through for us for a ridiculous request. Amen. We want to provoke God. God, if you will do it, but we never say, God, when you do it. I want someone here to say, God, it's not if you're going to do it, but it's going to be what? When you do it. If I got to have, I've been talking over here. It's not if you're going to do it, but it's what? When you're going to do it. And God, and when you do it, God, I'm going to make sure that I give you what? A praise like I have never given to you before. But by show of hands, has God showed up for you already right now? Amen. When everybody else walked away, and God still show up right now. Y'all not talking to me this morning. I'm not trying to come around it yet. It's not time for me to come over and be back. I want somebody to say, God has showed up for me already. Amen. Despite of what I wanted, he still showed up in another way. Despite of what I got, he still showed up in another way. I want some testimonies this morning. Said, God, thank you for always being there for me. Amen. When it seems as though the end has always been close to me.
Come on now.
The word of God that we read here said, brothers, if someone is caught in any wrongdoing, you who are spiritual should restore such a person with a gentle spirit. I'm going to talk out of this verse here, Trace, because again, I said it's my now season. Amen. I want to make sure that my now season, make sure that I don't do nothing wrong to none of you in here or anybody. Amen. I want to make sure I give the same respect that someone give to me when they catch me in the wrong. Am I talking to somebody? I want someone to forgive me. I want someone to pray with me. I want someone to talk to me. I want someone to tell me, don't worry, you didn't get it right this time, but amen. But there is a next time. I want someone to talk to me when they catch me in the wrong and said, amen, from a spiritual, they don't talk to me in a worldly way, because some of y'all can be kind of cruel talking to me in a worldly way. I want someone to talk to me in a spiritual way, tell me that although you slipped up and messed up, amen, God still can use you. Am I talking to somebody? Although you're still afflicted with pain and illness, God still can heal you. I know you don't have what you think you should have. Don't worry, God can give you what abundance of whatever you need. Amen. I want someone to talk to me in a spiritual mindset. Although you're in a bad situation, amen, but joy comes in the morning. I want someone to talk to me on that spiritual side and say, we fall down, amen, but we get up, amen. I want someone to talk to me in a spiritual standpoint and say, just hang on just a little while longer, amen. Everything is going to work out for those who love the Lord.
Amen.
Brothers, if someone is caught in wrongdoing, you who are spiritual, that's talking to you church folks in here. You know, I told you last week, church folks can be those difficult ones. Church folks can be those ones that love you right now but stab you in your back later on. Church folks can be the same one that give you praise but be the same one that down you to everybody else's mouth. Am I talking to somebody? Church folks can be the same one that think you got it good and think you got it made, but they don't understand that you crawled in here and you drove in here on E. Amen. Church folks can say amen. That you think you're better than me, but they don't understand that I'm 1 second or 1 minute away from what? Jumping off a bridge. Am I talking to someone? Church folks can automatically assume that everything is good in your life, but they don't understand, amen, how many times you had to pray, amen, before you got up this morning. Am I talking to somebody? I'm not talking about waking up, but I'm talking about getting up off your knees. I want to talk to somebody in that got some old dried up, rusty, beat up knees, amen, because you stay praying to the Lord right now, amen. Am I talking to some prayer warriors here right now saying, you don't understand, church folks, amen, things that I go through, amen, because if God wasn't on my side, I don't know where I would be right now. This is my what? Now season.
My now season. Come on.
Spiritual, you spiritual folks should restore such a person with a gentle spirit, watching out for yourselves so you also won't be tempted.
Come on.
Watching out for yourself so that you also won't be tempted. We got church folks, auntie, mingling with church folks, trying to talk to them on a worldly level, I can't say spiritual level, and if you're not careful, you also be tempted to also engage in worldly talk, worldly mess, worldly habits. You have to be able to what? Guard yourself so that you also won't fall by the wayside like they are falling. Y'all got quiet on me. I want to talk to somebody that you ever talk to some people, amen, amen, and by the way that they are talking and the stuff that they are doing, you find yourself talking and doing the same stuff that they are doing. Am I talking to any believers? Amen. You've been tempted, amen, a time or two, amen, by listening to some of the mess and stuff that they are doing. You got to guard yourself to make sure that you yourself don't turn out to be just like they are, Tracy. You got to make sure that you don't start talking just like they talk. You got to start making sure, thinking that you don't act the way that they are acting. Amen. I'm talking about those lukewarm people. Those people are seasoned, those people. You get what I'm saying? I said, this is my season now. Amen. Meaning that sometimes people got to get up out of your season in order for you to what? Walk into your season. Amen. Praise in your season. Amen. Dance in your season. And worship in your season. Is there anybody here right now saying, get up out of my season because it's my what? Season now. I don't need for no corruption. I don't need anyone else in here right now. Amen. That's going to what? Cause my season to fail.
Amen.
Then we hit it here again in verse 2. It said, carry one another's burdens in a way you will fulfill the law of Christ. For if anyone consider himself to be something when he is nothing. Come on.
Come on, Pastor.
For they always think that they're something But actually, you're nothing. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? You got those people who think they are better than you. Amen. But the word of God tells me you're nothing. Amen. When you think that you're better than your fellow brother or your fellow sister. Am I talking to anybody? I want to make sure, amen, you don't get beside yourself in this Christian walk, in this spiritual walk, amen. When you think that you got it going on, amen, sometimes you ain't got nothing going on. Am I talking to somebody?
Come on.
When you place yourself above everybody else, amen, be careful how you treat me, amen, going up, amen, because you're going to see me on your way back down. Am I talking to somebody? When you think that you all that, amen, my father said that you are what? Nothing.
Say it again. Nothing.
Nothing. It's in your word right there. Amen. When you think that you're something, be careful. Amen. Because you may end up being nothing. You got to watch yourself how you're going up. Amen. Because it's a hard fall on your way back down. Y'all talk to me, greater faith. Amen. And no matter how high you go up and how low you may fall. Amen. I got some brothers and sisters in here right now saying, I don't care what you done to me. I don't care what you said to me. Amen. I don't care what you think about me. But I'm still going to show you love and compassion and help you get up off of that very ground that you crashed on. Is there any witness in here right now saying, I don't mind helping you? When you fall down. Anyone deep consider himself to be something when he is nothing. It says this, right? He deceives himself.
All right, say it again.
He deceives himself. But the word in 4 said, but each person should examine his own work.
Come on.
Then he will have a reason. He will have a reason for boasting in himself alone, not in respect to someone else, for each other will have to carry his own load.
Man.
Let me get this right, D. So I got to examine my work. I got to examine my work.
Your work.
Auntie, I got to examine my work. D said, I got to examine my work. Maggie, Mata, I got to examine my work. Y'all get what I'm going here? I don't need for you to examine my work.
All right.
Because I'm not going to examine your work.
Come on, Pastor.
This is my season now.
Yes, it is.
This season only includes me and the stuff that I'm going through.
Right.
I'm going to examine myself by the progress that I have made. By the person that I'm changing from. I'm not going to examine you and bring you down and tell you what you're not doing. I'm not going to tell you what you should be doing. That is something between you and God.
Yeah.
I can just encourage you. Just keep on fighting. Keep on getting better. The problem that I have here with a lot of us is a lot of us want to examine your neighbor before you examine yourself. Am I talking to somebody? You want to examine me and all my problems before you examine and check yourself and all of your problems. Amen. In other words, get your hand out of my pocket and place your hand in your pocket. Check yourself before you check me. Am I talking to somebody? Get out of my mess and get out of my stuff and clean up your mess and clean up your stuff before you start to examine me. It's going to get quiet on this one. Am I talking to somebody here right now? You got your own season, amen, to work in, amen. You got your own season, amen, to praise and shout in. You got your own season to make some repairs, amen. But you can't do that, Trace, amen, because you all in my season. We're going to get there. It says there, examine yourself and your own work before you mess with mine. Amen. Too many of y'all are examining everybody else, but you're not checking your own stuff off the list. You know, Christmas already passed. You got to come up with a list, and you're checking it once, and you're checking it twice, and you're trying to find out, amen, who's been good and who's been nice, amen. But you got to ask yourself, have you been good? Have you been nice? Have you treated your fellow brothers and sisters with love and respect, amen? A lot of y'all are checking everybody else and you're demanding respect, amen, but you're not giving no respect. Am I talking to somebody here? You want somebody to respect you, amen, but you're not giving the same respect that you are requiring for somebody else, amen. I'm going to quit tattling with that right now. We got a little bit to go, amen. But then it says that you need to check yourself and check yourself alone and not in respect to someone else. For each person, auntie, will have to carry his own load. Your mess is your mess. Come on. My struggles are my struggles. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? Amen. The stuff that I go through, I told you last week, amen. I will stand alone. Amen. I will have to go through my pain and go through my struggles. Amen. Just keep the prayers coming. Am I talking to somebody? I may have to do this all by myself, but just keep it coming, y'all. Don't count me out. Amen. Just because I may be weak and weary and worn and beat down, don't give up on me. Amen. Because I tell you, just go on. I'm going to be all right. Amen. But I'm going to do the same thing. Amen. I'm going to pray for you because I find out this great faith. And a lot of times y'all tell us y'all problems. Y'all tell us y'all struggles, right? You tell us you want us to pray for you. We pray for you. And then we intercede for you. We fast for you. We do everything we're supposed to, right? And then we think that it's been resolved, but you continue to what? Tamper with it. Amen. You continue to pick up what we have already put in the ground. Am I talking to somebody? You keep revisiting how it used to be. Amen. You keep going back to the place where you were broken. You keep going back to the place where you was rejected. You keep going back to the place where they hurt you. You keep going around the same people that talked about you and misused you. Amen. Just give me 1 second. Amen. In other words, amen, if you're not going to leave it alone, amen, don't put it on my doorstep. Amen. Don't give it to me to pray about. Amen. If you don't believe that God is going to manifest it and God is going to do it, amen, just walk away from it. Am I talking to somebody? You saying that, man, God must not like me. Amen. You say God must not hear my prayers. Amen. What took place there, Deacon? Amen. You only prayed to him on a Friday. Amen. You had a whole year and you only prayed to him on a Friday. Amen. Because you know that Monday is due. Amen. You know that Monday morning is coming around. Amen. You only prayed, amen, when you was in distress. Amen. You only asked him for forgiveness. Amen. Because you got caught. Amen. Talking to somebody. You only ask of God, amen, when you need God. Amen. Someone right now said, I'm going to handle this problem that I got right now all by myself. And then it says in 6, the one who is taught the message, the one who is taught the message must share all his good things with the teacher. Don't be deceived. God is not to be mocked. For whatever a man sow, he will also reap. I'm reading it. It says that whatever a man sows there, auntie, he will also reap. Because the one who sows to his flesh will reap corruption from the flesh. But the one who sows to the Spirit will reap eternal life from the Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Can it mix, church? Can corruption and of the Spirit, can it mix? Can I have corruption in my life and still have the Spirit of God in my life? Can I still be a corruptive person and still shout and tell you how good God is? And can I mix both of them together like Kool-Aid and sugar and think that it's going to be sweet? Can I put it together right now like some cake mix there, auntie? Can I put corruption inside of my worship? Can I put corruption inside of my everyday lifestyle? Am I talking to someone? Can I have corruption? Can I just have a little corruption and think that everything is going to be all right? Can I have a little corruption and thinking that God's still going to favor me? Can I still have corruption and still think that everything is going to be all right? Am I talking to somebody? Can I have corruption? corruption, deacons, amen, and still have the Holy Spirit, amen, all in the same body, amen. Am I talking to somebody? Can I still be a corrupted person, but still talking about I'm going to get my praise on only to walk back out of the church now, back to being a corrupted person? Can I come in here and preach today and go back outside those doors and be a corrupted person? Can I come in here and shout and lose your wigs and lose your sweat, amen, and go back out those doors and be a corrupted person? Am I talking to somebody? Can I still be corrupted, amen, and still be a what God fearing man? I got to say, amen, you got it all twisted, amen, because two spirits cannot dwell in the same body, amen. You cannot love two masters, amen, because the word said, amen, you're either going to love one or you're going to hate the other. Am I talking to somebody? Said something got to give, amen. If I'm going to love the Lord, amen, I got to love him with all my heart, amen. If I'm not going to love him, amen, I might as well stay what? Corrupted. I'm going to get there. I'm holding it in for the grand finale with this, amen. You cannot live, continue to live a corrupted lifestyle and think that, amen, everything is going to be okay. The word tells you if you live a corrupted lifestyle, you won't get the spirit, but you will get the flesh. Am I talking about it? Anybody here? You will get everything that the world has to offer you. Amen. How many of y'all love what the world is offering? How many of y'all love being inside the world? How many of y'all truly love to hear from the world? How many of y'all love hearing worldly people is calling your name and patting you on your back and showing you accolades? How many of y'all truly love what the world is doing for you? Is there anybody here right now? I want to raise their hand and say, I love what the world is doing for me. Amen. It gives me joy. It gives me peace. Or is there anybody here saying, I love what the Holy Spirit is doing in my life? I love what the Holy Spirit has done in my life. I love what the Holy Spirit is showing in my life. Is there anybody by a show of hands right now saying, I love what the Lord is doing in my life? I love what the Holy Spirit has done for me, because you don't know my testimony. You don't know my story. Amen. When corruption was all in my life, it took for the Holy Spirit to stop by in my life, amen, to free me from corruption, to free me from sin. Is there anybody going to testify, say, you can have your corruption, just give me the Holy Spirit?
Amen.
It says that, and then I'm getting here, it says that you will reap eternal life from the Spirit. But here it says, so we must not get tired of doing good, for we will reap at the proper time if we don't give up. Therefore, since we have an opportunity, we must work for the good of all, especially of those belonging to the household of faith. Amen. Is there anybody right now saying, I love working for God? I love working for Jesus. I love doing good. Is there anybody right now tired of doing good? Is there anybody right now saying, I'm tired of being good? Amen. It seems as though I'm good all the time, but I'm getting stabbed. I'm getting stepped on. I'm getting talked about. I'm getting rejected. I love what doing good. Amen. Again, and when we're getting ready to wrap this up, I love what it says. It said that you will, don't get tired. Don't get tired. It said, for we will reap at a proper time if we don't give up. Brings me to this thing. Let's get ready to close it out. Brings me to this moment right here. Is that all the stuff that you have been through, all the stuff that you have endured, I'm telling you right now that it was worth it. I had a season, Tracy, where I mourned. I had a season where I was in mourning. I mourned the death of loved ones, and of a father or of a mother. I was in a season, deacons, in greater faith, where I mourned. You know what mourning is? That I was crying. I was sad. I was asking God, why this and why that? They were good people. I'm mourning. And I was mourning the loss and the death of loved ones, but I also was mourning of broken relationships. I got to be talking to somebody. I was mourning. I was sad, amen, because the relationship didn't turn out how I wanted to be or how I expected. It caused me to go into mourning, whether it be a person that you love or even a family member. Come on. I was mourning because a family member just couldn't see the good in you or couldn't see the good in me. I was mourning because no longer would we be able to talk, amen, because God is taking me into a different place and moving me on a different level. I was mourning. I was in a season there, Deacon, and greater faith where I was mourning. And then I was in another season there. And come on, I gotta be talking to somebody where I was lonely. Is there anybody here was in a season where you were lonely? It seemed as though you was all by yourself. Every time you wake up, there was no one laying in the bed with you. There was no one occupying the house. There was no one that was telling you that they love you. You was lonely, and some of us are still stuck in that season of lonely right now. Is there anybody gonna shout and praise him right now saying, I've been in a season where I was lonely, amen. I didn't have no friends. I didn't have my close family friends. I was in a season, Deacon, where I was all by myself, amen. Watch this part, Deacon, the greatest thing. I was in a season of lonely, amen. Because when I stepped away from the world, I was all by myself. I was no longer doing the stuff that I used to do, amen. So that means that everybody had to what depart from me. And I didn't tell them to leave, but they chose to leave. Am I talking to somebody? The five heartbeats of flash said that it was. It's lonely sometimes, amen. When you're at the top, amen. Got to talk to somebody. It's lonely when you at the top. And I'm not talking about top of the world, but I'm talking about it's lonely when you at the top of your praise right now, amen. See, I was lonely, amen, in a season when I couldn't give God no praise. I was lonely when I couldn't recognize that God was still moving on my behalf. I was lonely, amen, because I thought that I need you. I thought that I needed it. I thought that I wanted more of it. Is there anybody going to testify and say, I was lonely, amen, because when they died on me or when they walked out of my life, amen, hey, I thought that I was going to be in the rest of my life, but by myself. I was lonely. I was in a season of being broke. Amen. I was in a season of brokenness. Amen. Is there anybody in here? I was in a season of brokenness. Amen. Meaning is that I couldn't even pick myself up to come to church. Amen. I couldn't pick myself up to pray. I couldn't pick myself up to worship. I couldn't pick myself up to give God no thanks. I was so broken, Deacon Darrell, amen, that I couldn't recognize, amen, who was still calling my name. I was so broken, amen. I didn't know. I couldn't see my way out of a jail cell when the doors was already open. I'm talking to somebody. I was already broken, amen, not realizing that God was putting me back together. Am I talking to somebody? I was so broken, Trace, amen, that I couldn't call the name of Jesus, amen. I was so broken. Am I talking to somebody, amen, that it wasn't the pain, amen, but it was the guilt and it was the shame, amen, that kept me in a state of brokenness. I was so broke, amen, that am I talking to somebody, that I was dragging my broken pieces everywhere that I go. I was so broken, amen, that I wanted you to be broken. Am I talking to somebody? I was so broke, amen, that I couldn't see, amen, that God was already making a way for me to come back. I was so broke. Am I talking to anybody that ever been broken before? Said I was in a season of brokenness, amen, until God was what put me back. Back together. Hey, watch this part. I was in a season of brokenness, but I also was in a season where I was broke. Am I talking to somebody? I was in a season where I was broke. I couldn't even ask you for no money because you didn't have no money. I couldn't ask my family members that they didn't have no money. Am I talking to somebody? I was so broke, amen. I couldn't even get a part-time job to help me out with my broke, amen. I was so broke, amen, that everybody stopped trusting me even though I had good credit. Am I talking to somebody? I went to a finance company and tried to get a loan, amen. Am I talking to any believers here, amen? And all you wanted them to do was to trust you and give you a chance, amen. But you were so broke, amen, they couldn't give you the loan, amen. They said, we want to help you out, amen. But looking at your credit, amen, we just can't see how you're going to pay us back, amen. And then you walk out of that place, amen, and ask yourself, amen, who can I get, amen, to help me with a little bit of money, amen. I called my uncle, amen. I called my mother, amen. I called my father, amen. I called my best friend, amen. I called everybody, amen, to see if they had a little bit of money, just a little bit, not a lot. Am I talking to somebody saying, I called everybody, amen, but they couldn't help me out, amen. Where are the people say, I was broke, amen, but somehow and some way, amen, Jesus stepped in and helped my pockets, amen, and look at me right now, amen. It wasn't the monetary that he stepped in and gave me, but he gave me a praise, amen, yeah. That when I get broke again, amen, I know who to call. Am I talking to anybody? Wait.
Jesus.
A season of brokenness and a season of being broke, right? Right? I want to talk to the people who was in a season of depression. Amen. We're getting there. I want to talk to the people who was in a season of depression. Meaning is that your mind was playing tricks on you. Amen. Meaning is that everything that you think or everything that you did, it depressed you. Amen. The same people start talking about stuff. Amen. They talk about love, you get depressed. Amen. They talk about God, you get depressed. Amen. They talk about their mothers or their father, you get depressed. Amen. Am I talking to somebody who's been in a season of depression? Amen. And you just couldn't find a way out of depression. Amen. Amen. The voice was telling you, go ahead and kill yourself. Amen. The voice was telling you, go ahead and give up. Am I talking to somebody who was in a season of depression? Amen. Where the sun never shined. Amen. Nobody, no matter what they say, you just couldn't lift yourself up. Amen. No matter what you did, you couldn't find yourself out of it. Amen. I'm talking to the depressed people. Amen. Because the doctor didn't give you the answer that you was looking for. Am I talking to somebody here? Amen. The one that you truly want to be with didn't love you. Am I talking to somebody who was in a season of depression at the hands of somebody else? Am I talking to somebody? Amen. You depressed, amen, because of what they think of you. You depressed, amen, because of what they did to you. You depressed, amen, because they don't love you. They don't want to talk to you, amen. You depressed, amen, because your job, amen, don't give you enough money. Am I talking to somebody? You depressed because mother is not here no more. Father is not here no more. Grandmama is not here no more. Brother is not here. Is anybody right now saying, I was in a season of depression, amen, because everybody left me to go on to be with the Lord, amen. But somehow, somewhere, amen, Jesus stepped in and gave me my way out. Hold tight. A season, right? A season of brokenness, a season of being broke, a season of depression, amen. A season, what was the season that y'all remember that was there? A season of pain, affliction. That's right now. I was in a season, and I'm getting ready to wrap it up, Auntie. I was in a season of pain. I was in a season of pain, y'all. A season, if I'm talking to somebody, see, I'm going down a season. It's not just winter, spring, fall, or summer, amen. But we got seasons that we go through, amen. And it outweighs those four seasons, amen. Because sometimes they can be what? More than we can count, amen. But a season of pain there, Megan. I was in a season of pain, amen. Because I was what? Betrayed, amen. Come on, I'm talking to somebody. I was deceived. Amen. I was overlooked. Amen. I was in a season of what they talked about. Man. I was in a season where my body wasn't acting right. I was in a season where I couldn't get up out of the bed some morning. Am I talking to anybody? Just let me know in my testify. Am I telling your story? Amen. I was in a season, amen, of pain. Amen. That no matter what medicine I took, amen, my body was still filled with pain. No matter what I did, amen, I still was in pain. I was in a season of pain there, Trace. Amen. No matter what good came my way, I still felt angry. I still felt what I want to get some get back. Am I talking to somebody? I was in a season there, Auntie, where I felt more pain, amen, than I felt of good times. Amen. Am I talking to somebody? A season of pain, amen, that's turned into a lifetime of pain. Am I talking to somebody? Some of y'all are just, y'all not even in pain, but because your mind has been afflicted with pain all this time, amen, you start to think there's pain in your body, and there's no pain in your body. Some of y'all have become so-called dependent on medicine that you wake up and take medicine, and there's nothing wrong with you. Some of y'all are in pain right now because the person been gone out of your life, and you're still crying for them. Still today, am I talking to somebody that's in a season of pain that you shouldn't be in? Well, hold on. We're almost there. A season of pain. A season of affliction. Amen.
Jesus.
Wrapping this up, Dean. I told you the sermon was entitled that this is my now season. Come on. Before I get to the highlight of the sermon, I want to give you one more season. Come on. I want to give you one more season. Am I talking to somebody? Can I give you one more season? Can I give you one more season? Amen. I was in a season when I didn't trust God. Hey, is there anybody here right now? Can we come on? Come on, y'all testify with me. I was in a season where I couldn't Facebook Live, are you on here? Because Greater Faith Inside here, they kind of wants to say, amen. I want some people to testify and just tell me right now that I was in a season where I couldn't and I didn't trust God. Amen. God, you let me down the first time. God, why did you disappoint me, God? God, why did you let them do that to me, God? Amen. God, you said that I could have anything in your name, God, and I still haven't received what I asked, what, for 13 or 15 years ago, God. I trusted you, God, and you turned your back on me. Am I talking to somebody? Amen. Is there ever been in that season that you didn't trust God? Amen. You threw up your hands. Amen. You said, God, you haven't stepped in and shown me anything, so I don't trust you, God. Amen. I don't trust you until I'm able to, like my man, the pastor said last night, I'm able to put my hands, like my fingers, where the holes went through. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because, amen, I'm already on my fifth or my sixth visit to the doctor and nothing has happened. I can't trust you, God. I still live in the projects. I still live in a one-bedroom apartment. I still drive a beat-up car. I still got more bills than money. I can't trust you, God. Y'all, I must be the only one to say I can't trust you. God, I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because you still ain't seeing me, that person that I asked for. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because when I roll over in the morning, That bed is empty, God. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because that family member and I are still not on one accord. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because I keep coming to church and I can't hear from you, God. I can't trust you, God. Because church members are still acting out of control. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because your word is true, but they're not living a true life. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because I'm still asking you for stuff. I'm still needing stuff, God. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Because I still feel all by myself. I can't trust you, God. Because I have nowhere to go. Amen. Yeah. My kids don't have their father. My kids don't have their mother. I can't trust you, God. Amen. Is there anybody right now saying, but I've been in a season when I couldn't trust him. Amen. But wait. Amen. But God somehow, amen, some way, amen, showed up and restored my trust. Amen. Yes. Anybody said, thank you, God. Amen. Thank for you. Showing up and restoring my trust.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
As he showed up to restore your trust. And all I do now is what? Trust him. Amen. Is there anybody right now saying, it doesn't matter if he don't show up right now, but I'm still going to what? Trust him. It don't matter if he going to do anything for me, but I'm still going to trust him. It don't matter if you love me or not, I'm still going to trust him. I don't care who's in my house or who's not, but I'm still going to trust him. I don't care if I don't get a job or lose a job, but I'm still going to what? Trust him. Someone said, because he's never, never, ever fail me. Is there anybody here right now saying he has never, ever,
never
failed?
Amen. Never.
Brings me to the final point. Close your Bibles. It's a wrap. It's over. It's my now season. It's my now season. See, I gave you that. If you wrote them down, I gave you those seasons for a reason. Each one of them seasons has pushed you into your now season. Come on. Am I talking to someone? Each one of them seasons has pushed you into the woman and the man that you are right now. Amen. If I never experienced any no pain, then I wouldn't know what it feels like to praise him. Amen. If I never been broke, then I never know what it feels like to praise him. Come on, y'all. If I never experienced some people walked out of my life, then I would never know what it feels like to experience. Is there anybody going to shout and praise him right now? I'm so thankful right now that I'm able to praise him and thank him. I can hug myself. Amen. I can love on myself right now. Someone said, it's my now season. Amen. All the stuff that I went through, amen, has made me the man that I am. All the stuff that I've been through and been broken has made you the woman that you are. Someone shout right now and say, it's my now season. Amen. You didn't want to see me in another season. Amen. But thank goodness I'm in my now season. Amen. Because I'm able to sleep at night. Amen. Even though I may still be feeling some type of way. Amen. But I'm able to rejoice. Amen. In the morning. Someone said I'm able to rejoice in the morning. Give him praise. Amen. Because it's my now season. Amen. What I don't have now. Amen. I'm still going to praise him. Amen. What I've been through right now, I'm still going to thank him, auntie. Amen. I want someone to say it's my now season. Amen. I'm able to cry. Amen. I'm able to worship. Amen. I'm able to praise him right now. Someone said, it's my now season. Amen. Because I don't have to have everything. Amen. Someone said, I just need a little Jesus, amen, in my now season, amen. I just need a little, everything's going to be all right, amen, in my now season, amen. I need some people say that, I'm what? And I'm giving them praise, amen. I'm shouting, saying thank you, God, amen, for bringing me what? From a what? Mighty long way. Someone say, it's my now season. It's your now season to give him praise. You've been broken, you've been hurt, you've been afflicted, you've been talked about, you've been overlooked, and you still not praise him. Amen. This is the season that we're going to praise God and thank him. Amen. Is there anybody right now that can just shout right now and just say, thank you, God, right now for my now season, God. Thank you for having me in a season, amen, where I can give you praise and give you honor and just wake up every morning feeling good, amen, knowing I'm faced with adversity, still wake up and say, it is what it is, amen, but I'm still going to praise, amen. Come on, y'all not shopping. I can wake up and give God thanks and really mean it, amen. Look around the house, amen, everything is fine, amen. Look around the outside, amen, everything is fine, amen. Get to the church and look at y'all and say, thank you, God, right now for what? My now season. This is your season. Right now. To praise him. Stop the complaining. Stop saying what you don't have. And say what I do have, what? Right now. You got a voice and you got a praise on the inside of you that you should be giving God praise, what? Right now. And deacons, I say this because we say it all the time. Don't wait till the battle is over.
Shout now.
Shout right now. Shout right now. Give him praise right now. Come on, y'all. Give him some praise right now. All the stuff that is done, you should be praising. All the people you removed out of your life, you should be praising. Amen. All the detours that you didn't see, you should be praising. Amen. All the cancer, all the heart pain, all the stuff that's out of your body right now, you should be what? Praising. Am I talking to somebody? Amen. All those naysayers that's out of your life, you should be what? Praising him. It's your now season. Your now season means that right now is the best time ever for you to get what God has for you.
Thank you, Lord.
God has a purpose. God has a plan, and he has a will. He will get it, and he will perform that purpose. This is your now. Jesus. You can't go back, Great Faith. And I say that right now to us as a church. This is our now season.
Amen.
This is our now season. Here it is. Project Nehemiah. Yeah. Come on. Project Nehemiah. Come on, church, come on. A lot of our family and friends don't know it, but then we have a project. Trace is on the books. We said that it's our Nehemiah project. Rebuilding the walls. It's now, church. Whatever you've been going through, whatever you've been afflicted with, wipe it out. It starts what? Right now. Whatever your pain you feel, whatever resentment you may have against someone, and me included, it starts right now. I see it. Come on. It starts right now. Come on, y'all. Come on. Praise him right. It starts right now. Come on. It starts right now. Come on. Someone shout it with me. Great of faith. Take it out of your pocket. Put it in here. Say it started right now. Obey.
Right now.
Take it out. Put it in the air. Shout it out. Trace, we have to inform you. You've been out of town. Put it in the air. Gonna do it every week. Shout with me again while we wait up and say, it is my now season.
My now season.
Come on, someone shout with me and say, it's my now season. Put it high up, wave and say, it's our now season.
Our now season.
There it is, it's up there, it's our now season.
Nehemiah.
Rebuilding the walls. It's now. You can't go back now.
Can't go back.
You can't go back.
Yeah.
You can't go back. And be honest with you, close it out. How would you look if you went back? Come on. How would you look if you went back? And I say that and I close out. I say that, man. Look at you now. You look good. You at peace. You're alive. Talk to me. You look good. You look good. You're dressing good. Smelling good. And you got everything. Like I said, you're good, Dick, right? You look good. The problem is that when you try to go back, you wouldn't fit in.
Amen.
Come on, praise now. Come on.
Amen.
Come on. You go back now. You wouldn't fit in.
Amen.
You wouldn't fit in. You can't go back. Because God has put you together. And then you go back and look at them. They're not together. You can't go back to the way that it used to be.
Amen.
Come on, church. Come on, praise Him. Someone say, I look good.
Can't go back.
This is my now season. Come on, y'all. Praise Him. Come on, give God some praise right now. This is my now season.
Amen.
I can't and I will not go back.
Can't go back.
I'm better. Much better.
Stronger,
look good. You look good at every day. Back then, you look rough. I'm smoking, drinking, partying, late night staying out. Where's the body now? Come on. But now, you able to get some sleep at night.
Amen.
Come on, y'all. You able to get some sleep in. And some of y'all probably go to sleep right now at 8:30. That's probably too late right now for the ones who don't have to work at night. But this is your season of now. Shout it with me real quick. This is my now season.
This is my now season.
Did y'all write that down today? This is my now season. And I won't go back. Come on, y'all. Give God some praise. Come on. Come on, y'all stand up on our feet right now in our now season. Come on, y'all.
You make
He will make it all right. And again, this is my now season. I'm in a season of now. Everything that I put my mind and my heart to and put my trust in God is going to happen. This is my now season. The doors of the church are now open. You can come by letter, Christian experience, candidate for baptism, the fourth one for restoration. Amen. Come on, y'all. Amen. God, we just thank you for what you're doing here at Greater Faith. Keep us, amen, in your prayers. Is there anybody right now that would love to give their life over to Jesus? Make this your now season. This is a season of now.